of relieving poor Mrs. Price entirely from the charge and expense of one child out of her great number. The trouble of it to us would be nothing compared with the benevolence of the action. If we were to undertake the care of the eldest daughter...
The daughter? But the girl must be thoroughly provided for, Mrs. Norris, or there'd be cruelty instead of kindness in taking her from the family. And in time there'd be work to do to find a suitable connection. Or expense will never end. You're not aware, perhaps, that Mr. Crawford visited me again this morning. His errand, you may conjecture.
No, sir.
To declare himself your lover, Fanny.
No, I can't be satisfied without Fanny Price. Without making a small hole in her heart.
I thought her an admirable heroine, Edmund. Chaste and lovely.
You didn't consider our hero deserved her affections.
Not at all, for she loved someone else.
Hopelessly.
But faithfully.
When I think of you all day, I dream of you all night.
Mr. Crawford!
I want you to accept this gift, Fanny. Take it as a token of the love of one of your oldest friends.
A gold chain!
William's Cross to wear tomorrow at the ball.
Oh, perfectly neat and simple!
And I endeavour to consult the simplicity of your taste.
Beautiful indeed. And it comes at such an acceptable moment, I can't attempt to thank you, Edmund.
My dear Fanny, you feel these things a great deal too much.
Oh, but I feel much more than I could possibly express.
You've proved yourself upright and honourable, now prove yourself grateful and tender-hearted. Then you'll be the perfect model of a woman which I've always believed you born for.
Never, Edmund, never, never. He never will succeed with me.
So very determined, never. This isn't like your rational self.
I must go, let me go.